Peace be with you. My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Through the fruitful virginity of Blessed Mary bestowed on the human race the grace of eternal salvation. Grant, we pray, that we may experience the intercession of her through whom we were found worthy to receive the author of life, our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord said to Moses, "Speak to Aaron and his sons and tell them, 'This is how you bless the Israelites. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look kindly upon you and give you peace.' So shall they invoke my name upon the Israelites, and I will bless them." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Brothers and sisters, when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to ransom those under the law, so that we might receive adoption as sons. As proof that you are sons, God sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying out, "Abba, Father." So, you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then also an heir through God. The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The shepherds went in haste to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that they had been told about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told them by the shepherds. And Mary kept these things, reflecting on them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them. When 8 days were completed for his circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. This is the gospel of the Lord. Dear friends, it's a great privilege to be able to celebrate this Eucharist as we end an old year and begin a new one. For many years now, this Mass on the Feast of Mary, Mother of God, has been celebrated as a pro-life Mass here in the Archdiocese of Boston. Last year, we gathered at St. Clement's Shrine with so many young people and look forward next year to be able to accept the hospitality of the Oblates of the Virgin Mary when we can bring people together personally for a holy hour and a Mass to conclude the old year and to bring in a new year, honoring our Blessed Mother and recommitting ourselves to the work of the Gospel of Life. Sadly, this year end has seen an expansion of abortion here in Massachusetts and in other states, and now in Argentina. We've likewise seen so many executions taking place. Tonight, as we formulate our resolutions for a new year, we want to recommit ourselves to defend life in a consistent fashion across the spectrum of existence from conception to natural death. Our commitment to human dignity includes our unwavering opposition to abortion, capital punishment, physician-assisted suicide. We also continue to defend life by protecting immigrants and refugees seeking our assistance, by serving the poor in our communities, and by a constant appeal to others in our society to see the fragile ties which hold us together as a community. We must strive to be better people, to live our discipleship more coherently, courageously, generously, and joyfully, so as to be able to change people's hearts. Our commitment to the Gospel of Life is to work for just laws in our land and in our world. But most of all, we want to work to change people's hearts so that there will always be a place at the table for every child that comes into this world. We are so grateful to Marianne Luthien, who was with us tonight for this Mass and was good enough to do the readings. She is a true apostle for life and has been involved in every aspect of the pro-life activities of the Archdiocese. We're particularly grateful for the work that she, her team, and volunteers do for Project Rachel. I also want to thank the Knights of Columbus for their unwavering commitment and for the ultrasound equipment that has saved literally thousands of lives. Today, as we celebrate Mary's motherhood, which took place under difficult circumstances, we want to pray for all the women who are struggling in difficult pregnancies, in a whole host of circumstances such as poverty, homelessness, addiction, violence, and all the losses brought about by the pandemic. We pray for women in these dire circumstances and offer to help them in any way that we can. We pray for birth mothers who have made the courageous decision of entrusting their child to a loving adoptive family. We pray for those families that joyfully and generously adopt the child and make it one of their own. We too pray for those couples who have been unable to conceive and long to have children. We entrust all of these intentions to the loving care of Mary, the Mother of God and our Mother. You know, in most countries of the world, Mother's Day is observed in the month of May, which happens to be the month of the Blessed Mother. Some Catholic countries celebrate Mother's Day on August the 15th, the Feast of the Assumption of Our Lady. But I would say that the Church's Mother's Day is today, January the 1st, the Feast of Mary, the Mother of God. It takes place 1 week after the observance of the birth of Christ. And like the shepherds who went to Bethlehem, we gather to congratulate Mary on the birth of her Son, who is both God and man, Christ, the Savior of the world. Mary is Christ's first disciple, who says yes to God, and in doing so, changes the course of history. Mother Teresa used to like to say, "Give God permission." At the Annunciation, God sends the angel Gabriel to tell Mary that she has been chosen to be the mother of the Messiah. Mary, without understanding how all of this could happen, with great faith and trust, embraces the will of God and says, "Be it done unto me according to thy word." From that moment, she was the mother of Christ, who became incarnate in her womb at Nazareth. In the Basilica of the Annunciation, there is a grotto where the actual Annunciation took place. They've erected an altar there with the Latin inscription, "Hic verbum caro factum est." Here, the Word of God became flesh. 9 months later, Mary gives birth to Christ in the stable at Bethlehem. After the miraculous conception of this child, Mary could have expected a more glorious and glamorous venue for his birth. But Mary is a disciple who walks by faith alone, always trusting in God's loving plan. We begin this new year celebrating her motherhood and faithfulness narrated at the beginning of the Gospel, where she becomes the Mother of God. At the end of the Gospel, Jesus from the cross gives her to us as our mother. "Behold thy mother," Jesus says. Today we rejoice that Mary is the mother of Christ and our mother as well. The custom was, when I was a young priest, that on Holy Thursday we would wash the feet of 12 men representing the 12 apostles at the Mass of the Lord's Supper. Now, in an Hispanic parish, it was never easy to convince 12 men to be willing to have their feet washed in public and in church. A lot of the men didn't think that was very macho. One year, one of my apostles, that's what we call the men who had their feet washed, had to work or fell sick and was unable to be there at the last minute, and I had to go and seek a volunteer in the church right before Mass, and I latched on to some unsuspecting soul and invited him into the sacristy to join the other men who were going to have their feet washed. He had no idea what he was getting into and was very shocked when he realized what was going to happen. The interesting thing is that that experience of having his feet washed as part of the Holy Thursday Mass and representing one of the apostles at the Last Supper had such a profound effect on that man, who before that very seldom went to church. That night he was there because of his wife or his girlfriend had dragged him there. But after that he came to Mass every Sunday and became very active in the community. He explained to me that that simple gesture made him realize that God had blessed him. And with God's blessing, he had to live a life of discipleship and service. It's not that he had not been blessed before, but at that moment, he realized that God was truly blessing him. When we come to realize God's gratuitous love for us and how he has blessed us, then we begin to live our lives differently. We come to know that we are never alone, that God's love engulfs us and never fails us, even when we fail him. Hopefully, at this Eucharist, we will realize that Jesus Christ has come to share our life, to wash our feet, and to invite us to be part of his family. Each year, our New Year celebration has, as the first reading, the Word of God is always taken from the book of Numbers in the Old Testament. It's where God is instructing Moses how the blessing was to be given to God's people through the priest Aaron. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. So shall the priest invoke my name upon the Israelites, and I will bless them. The same blessing was used constantly by St. Francis of Assisi. And sometimes we hear this very same blessing being given at the conclusion of Mass. But for me, it's very significant that the first word of God proclaimed each year in the liturgy is this blessing. We come to receive God's blessing and to ask God to bless this new year that begins today. In many countries, the custom is to sing the Te Deum, a hymn of praise and thanksgiving to God for all the blessings that we've received in the past year. Dag Hammarskjöld once wrote a simple prayer. He said, "For all that has been, thanks, Lord, thanks. For all that will be, yes, Lord, yes." That is a beautiful New Year sentiment. When we go for an eye examination, we're happy if the optometrist tells us that our vision is 20/20. However, the year 2020 for most of us doesn't betoken a good vision or a good year, but rather a challenging time that we're happy to see in the rearview mirror. Roma Downing has written a lovely book called The Box of Butterflies, in which she tries to discover all of the unexpected blessings around us. As we end 2020, we want to count our blessings, even the blessings in disguise. To me, one of the most interesting figures in the Gospels is Simon the Cyrenian. There's not too much information about him, but it can be fun to connect the dots and fill in with a little imagination and literary license. We know that Simon the Cyrenian was forced to help Jesus carry the cross to Calvary. Like many people in Jerusalem, he was there on Good Friday, milling around, coming home from work or going to the market, and suddenly he's grabbed by those Roman soldiers and forced to help this criminal carry his cross. How humiliating to be thrust into a public spectacle of this nature. I'm sure he was not just embarrassed, felt put upon, but certainly was angry, perhaps frightened. Scholars speculate that being from Cyrene, northern Africa, he was probably black and perhaps felt singled out for that reason. The curious thing is that what was the worst day in Simon's life turned out to be the best. I feel sure that in his old age, Simon gathered his grandchildren around and told them again and again about the day that he was chosen to help Jesus carry the cross. the day Simon became part of the gospel story. The New Testament speaks of two early leaders in the Christian community, Rufus and Alexander, and named them as being sons of Simon. Scholars have said that's probably the same Simon who helped Jesus carry the cross and was converted to Christianity subsequently and raised his sons in the faith. All of us have received so many blessings in disguise that have allowed us to overcome our limitations, to have a new and greater opportunities, to be better people. I have a dear friend whose wife has Alzheimer's, and he told me that this experience has made him a better man, a better husband. Many of us, like Simon of Cyrene, have been forced to carry the cross that we have not volunteered for. We may have done so begrudgingly, and perhaps only later did we discover that in those trying moments, we were so close to God and His love. This pandemic has occasioned so much suffering in our world, so much loss, so much death. As we end the year 2020, like Mary, we want to ponder all of these things in our heart and try to discover what God is saying to us and how close He is to us. We begin this new year on the Church's Mother's Day, asking Mary, our Mother, to help us to be better disciples and more conscious of the blessings we receive every day, even the blessings in disguise, which are often the most powerful ones and make us grow into better people. Happy New Year. Many blessings on you and your loved ones. We have listened to God's word and reflected upon it. Let us now make our response by praying together our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us confidently make known our needs to our Heavenly Father, who always hears our prayer with tenderness and love.
For the Church, that guided by the leadership of Pope Francis and Cardinal Seán, we may serve as joyful messengers of the gospel and faithful followers of Jesus Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
increased respect for the dignity of human life in our culture, that we all strive to build a culture of life where every life is cherished and protected at all stages. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families, that they will live out their unique vocation of love and nurture, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have or who are discerning to open their lives to adoption or foster care, that during this year devoted to St. Joseph, the foster father of Jesus, they may be supported in this loving way of building up family life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in vocations to the priesthood, religious life, and the sacrament of marriage, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all medical personnel and first responders who care so selflessly and courageously for the sick, the disabled, and the terminally ill, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace throughout the world and an end to the COVID-19 pandemic, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those who have died over the past year, and for all who will die alone this night, that they will be welcomed into the eternal kingdom of God's unconditional love and mercy, where every tear will be wiped away, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And we offer all of these petitions joyfully and confidently through the intercession of Mary, the Mother of God and our Mother, as together we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. O God, who in your kindness begin all good things and bring them to fulfillment, grant to us who find joy in the solemnity of the Holy Mother of God, that just as we glory at the beginning of your grace, so one day we may rejoice in its completion, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on the solemnity of the motherhood of the Blessed Ever-Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Father of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us
as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, with me, your unworthy servant, my assistant bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, tomorrow, today, and forever. Let us pray. We have received this heavenly sacrament with joy, O Lord. Grant, we pray, that it may lead us to eternal life, for we rejoice to proclaim the blessed ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of your Son and Mother of the Church, through Christ our Lord. Lord, be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Forever.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Heaven and earth.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.